Yamas Adonai Nagila Benismacha Bo. This is the day that God has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. It's not every day in a congregation's history that we get to welcome and install our chazan, a cantor. In this case, preferred is chazenet, our cantor. And so we are here to celebrate Cantor Becky Khitrik. And a big welcome to her and her entire family who has come and been able to join us here. So everybody wave here to the entire family. There they are. Welcome to Temple Sinai, especially if this is your first time here. We are so delighted to have you. We say front row just for you. Don't expect that they're always going to save the front row for you, however. We are going to have a beautiful musical program shared not only by Cantor Becky, but also by her teachers. And so it is my honor to also welcome our Cantor Emeritus, Cantor Jeff Klepper, Cantor Louise Treitman, Cantor Dr. Brian Mayer, and Cantor Lynn Torgo. A big welcome to you, and thank you so much for being here. And a big thank you to our Temple Sinai Choir, who will be joining us and helping us with music directed by Carol Martin. So everyone, I'd like to invite you to listen, to sing, to be here, to show your appreciation, to pray. I'd like to invite Essie Kaiserman and Jay Ritt, who will share a little bit about our morning and about our canton.
Good morning. Our mission was clear. Temple Sinai needed a new cantorial leader because our cantor of 18 years, beloved Jeff Klepper, retiring and leaving behind big shoes to fill. Temple President Joko Arnold and I were asked to lead a cantor search committee. 13 Temple Sinai members, best and the brightest. Okay, that's a bit of an exaggeration, but we were a dedicated and hardworking group. The committee comprised a broad section, of the congregation, some religious school parents, some long-term members, newer congregants, board members, choir members, and a handful of ritual committee members. We had enough people with different backgrounds and interests to ensure a mix of opinions. Input was obtained from many different sources within the temple and the broader Reform congregation community about what qualities we needed and wanted in our next cantorial leader. Some of the important characteristics we identified included passion for Jewish learning and Jewish music, an interest in working with young people, a desire to be an integral part of Temple Sinai community, outstanding musical talent, and of course, enthusiasm for all cantorial responsibilities. Just didn't want somebody with a great voice. Wanted so much more. So many diverse skills needed. We expected to conduct a long and challenging search. And then we interviewed Cantor Becky Khitrik.
The congregation knew her for her 3.5 years as our assistant cantor in a role of leading high holiday and some Shabbat services. In addition, she conducted multiple choir and tutored some of our B'nai Mitzvah students. But there was so much more about Cantor Khitrik that we did not know. During her interview, we discovered she had a great wealth of knowledge about Judaism, Jewish music, and enthusiasm for all facets of being a cantor. She loved teaching, working with youth, and wanted to engage the congregation in musical participation. She is deeply spiritual, extremely intelligent, and is clearly a warm person. She expressed a great respect for Rabbi Mesler and Cantor Klepper and was excited about becoming more connected to the Temple Sinai community. The entire Cantor Search Committee was blown away by her responses. Her interview hit all the right notes, and we realized the ideal search was over. We had found our next cantor of Temple Sinai. Since stepping on the Bima as our new cantor, Cantor Khitrik has been called upon to undertake many tasks and has shown herself to be equal to them all. She is a talented and capable leader of our Shabbat and B'nai Mitzvah services and has introduced some new melodies to the congregation. Her singing during the high holidays helped to open the vault of heaven to our prayers. During the Erev Shabbat service in September, when we discovered the building had been vandalized with graffiti, Cantor Khitrik provided calm and soothing presence on the Bima. We have a limited amount of time, so we won't even mention her multiple talents in playing the clarinet, piano, and guitar, her performances with the Kleswood Klezmer Band, and her upcoming teaching sessions at Temple Sinai in December on Trove. Before closing, we would like to say Yashir Koach to the Cantor Search Committee and Todah Rabah to the Cantor Installation Committee. All members are listed in the back of the program. We'd like to give a special thanks to Sherry Kalmowitz, Jill Goldberg-Arnold, and Melody Ritt for their help with this service. Becky has joined the clergy of Temple Sinai and knows she will captivate the congregation for years to come. And now, let's hear some music from the cantors.
Good morning. So let me tell you how it's going to work. I'm going to sing a line. You're going to sing a line. And I know you won't let me down. This mic's standing. Okay, it's not like we haven't done this before. Quickly they forget.
Hi everybody.
Hi.
Okay, a little nervous that here. Awesome. Yeah. Enigmato.
Enigmato.
Up ahead. Only one thing missing, and that's something you hear in every Jewish song, is a backbeat. Am I right, cantors? You gotta have the backbeat. You gotta take your hands and clap them like that, and don't stop now. hearts are filled with prayers and blessings for Cantor Khitrik, and especially thanks to God for bringing us here today. It's truly a Shehefion moment, and there's a song that we used to sing back in the old days, expressing our thanks from the prayer that says, if the love in our hearts was as much as water in the ocean, it would still be not enough to thank God for all the blessings we have. Ilu finu, male, shira, kayam. Let's see if you can repeat that. Ilu finu, male, shira, kayam. And if you need a reminder, it goes like this. Ilu finu, male, shira, kayam.
tell you a story about this melody. It's by Shlomo Carlbach. But I thought Becky wrote it. When Becky emerged on the scene at Hebrew College about a decade ago, and I was the dean of the School of Jewish Music, I invited her down to my pulpit in Providence to be part of this new band that we had started for our Friday night services called Shabbat Chai. And she was over for Shabbat dinner, and she was hanging out with my kids, and we discovered that she looks at 5 years old in a picture, just like my five-year-old did then. Identical, from the same genetics. And she was waltzing around the kitchen and the living room, and she had this sharpest joy about her. I got a little closer, and I heard that she was doing this. He put it to me, chamocha.
Shalom, 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 which means Zion Shalom. It should be, there should be, yes, Yiddish peace, it's all in Yiddish. So say for me, Zol Shoin Zion Shalom. Shalom, 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 shalom. Shalom, after Gans Abel, peace in the whole world. The verses then continue with Shabbos, Shabbos. There should be Shabbos, our whole world should be Shabbos. And the last verse is Freilach. There should be joy in the whole world. The joy of Yiddish, the joy of Jewish music, and the joy of the Jewish people. So here's the how it begins.
Thank you.
So when I was here for those 5 years for the high holidays, then I discovered I was leaving. I said, who would be the perfect person to take my place here? Thought about my students, our students. All of us had the pleasure of teaching Becky at Hebrew College. And I came up with the perfect solution. I thought about it, and then I talked to Becky about it. And she said, I'm interested in that job, sure. And then, unbeknownst to Jeff, I said, you know, Becky, I know that Jeff's gonna be retiring in the future. And, you know, he's a little younger than me, but he's probably gonna retire in the good timing for you to have a full-time job, or a big job, your own job. All here. And so I was thrilled that that's exactly what happened. So thank you, God, for making it happen. And thank you, Becky, for making it happen. You were the perfect person for that job, for this job. I'm so grateful that you're here, and I'm glad to be here too. So I taught you guys a special Shalom canon. It's not Sholem, this one is Shalom. And I hope you guys remember how to sing in four-part harmony. I'm sure you do. So let's try it. It goes like this. Let's sing all together first. Shalom, shalom.
To invite Cantor Becky Khitrik up to teach us.
won't just give you one teaching. Instead, I will share five teachings, one from each of my mentors here on the Beyond. Each of these individuals trained me, shaped me, gave me the diverse tools that qualified me to be here today, and perhaps most importantly, instilled in me a deep, deep love of the kindred. The role of a Chazan has undergone several shifts over the past decades, and the skill set that one needs to be a that one needs to create a successful singing community has broadened. If I am going to be able to fulfill the roles of your prayer leader, educator, and pastor, it is because of the guidance of the people sitting behind me. And I want to begin with a teaching from somebody who's actually not in your immediate line of vision, but is here today, and I'm so, so grateful for her presence. And that person is Carol Martin. Carol conducted a choir of cantorial students at Hebrew College 10 years ago, where I was enrolled as a first-year student. Incidentally, our choir then also came to Temple Sinai here one Friday night. Little did I know. Thanks to Carol, I was introduced to a broad spectrum of Jewish choral music. In fact, I still use Carol's repertoire book today when planning our choral programs here. The music in it spans centuries, from Salomone Rossi, a composer of the late Italian Renaissance, to pieces composed by some cantor named Jeffrey Klepper. Carol taught me that the Jewish choral tradition is as old as the history of our people. You can think of the Levi'im, the priests at the temple, as the first Jewish choir. And it now crosses over into genres of jazz and folk and even pop music. That this tradition has endured so long, even through its multiple evolutions, is a testament to the way that choral singing is relevant and important to our worship today. Teaching number two is also about enduring traditions, about the sense of authority and sanctity that our musical tradition has had over the centuries. Also about 10 years ago, cantor Dr. Brian Mayer introduced his Foundations of Ashkenazic Nusach class by reciting the opening verse of the first Mishnah of Pirkei Avot. Moshe kibel Torah miSinai u'sara liHoshua, viHoshua liZkenim uZkenim leNeviim, unVeim sarva leAnshei Knesset haTorah. Moses received the Torah at Sinai and transmitted it to Joshua, Joshua to the elders, and the elders to the prophets, and the prophets to the men of the great assemblies. That legacy, that line, why did the rabbis of the Mishnah feel it necessary to include that? Because all that follows comes directly from God, Sinai. For the better part of 2,000 years, that was the concept of Judaism that reigned. It wasn't really until the 19th century when it was being challenged by someone like Spinoza. The musical legacies and traditions of our liturgy, they are diverse. They have been met with controversy over the years. But similarly, they have serious heft. Some of the melodies, like Kol Nidre, project back to a mythic figure of authority, Moshe Rabbeinu, who, as the story goes, heard them on Mount Sinai along with the rest of the Torah. We Chazanim are keepers of that legacy, and that is why you may have heard me introduce different melodies for the Chatzi Kaddish on a Shabbat morning. Or for Chopin Ad this past Sukkot. Because when I use that nusach, the prescribed melodies and modes and motifs for certain times, I am honoring that age-old legacy. On the other hand, a good cantor knows that she must not muck too much with the customs of her congregation. Also in Cantor Becky's class, we learned about one of the greatest figures of cantorial authority, the Mavareel. He was born in, we think, 1357 or 1360, back into the 14th century. Yaakov Levy, Moreno Harav, the Machareel, he was a German Dayan Hussek, a prayer leader. In Siman 619 of Orach Chaim of the Shulchan Aruch, Moshe Israelis quotes a line from Sefer Machareel. Ba'al Mishane Adam Lemincha Ta'ir Afilu Hanigamim. One should not deviate from the local custom, even concerning the melodies and beauty that are recited there. This principle laid out in Orach Chaim also underscores the sense of authority and sanctity of musical traditions, and this time speaks to a specific local place. The Machareel was insistent that one should never be a shliach tzibor, a prayer leader, until one has experienced the traditions and customs of the community. That teaching provides a perfect segue to draw your attention to another cantor on the roof, Cantor Louise Triton, who, as you already now know, because she told the story that I was planning to tell, I would not be here today were it not for her. I'm just going to skip all of this. Cantor Kreitman had, of course, spent many years singing here on his Bema as your high holiday cantor. And in fact, this year, as I was preparing to leave Yiskor for Shmini Atzeret, I found Louise's old service outline that she had shared with me years ago in her accompanied repertoire class. I also had a large packet of music from that class, and suddenly I was finished with my preparations. Louise taught me about how to create musical flow in the service, but perhaps even more importantly, she taught me the lesson that a teacher is not just a purveyor of knowledge, but a source of mental and emotional support. When the School of Jewish Music was going through a difficult time, Louise was a rock, a comforting fortress of support to me and my classmates. And so with her in mind, I offer a teaching from this week's Torah portion, Chayei Sarah. You are likely familiar with the story. Abraham has sent his servant back to his homeland to find a wife for his son, Isaac. At the well, the servant meets Rivka, who offers to let him drink from her pitcher, and also leaps to draw water for his 10 camels. Vatomer shetei Adoni, vatemaher lotore kada aliyada vatashkehu. And she replied, "Drink, sir." Quickly she lowered her pitcher from her hand and let him drink. This quality of going the extra mile to help someone out, employing a strong work ethic and life to make the world brighter for others, Louise Triton exemplifies these characteristics, and I hope that I can be as supportive to my B'nai Mitzvah students here as she was to me and my fellow classmates at seminary. Another expert in support is Cantor Lynn Torkov, who was perhaps single-handedly responsible for helping me to find my voice, my singing voice, that is. Lynn reminds us all to go back to our breathing, take care of our bodies. In the beginning of my studies with Lynn, our voice lessons would involve lying on the floor on our backs and learning how to breathe properly. On Shabbat mornings at Temple Sinai, we read, Elohai neshama shana tatavi tevorahi. My God, the soul you placed in me is pure. The Hebrew word for soul, neshama, is connected to the word for breath. The particularities of who we are, our inner essences, are deeply connected to our life force, our breath. I could say more about this wonderful woman who is not just my teacher, but in some ways my soul sister. But instead, I'll invite you all to take a moment and breathe. Out of silence and breath, song. My last teaching this morning comes for the person who has created the most enormous legacy in this community, Cantor Jeff Clever. Jeff has taught me so many skills, both as a teacher at Hebrew College and as a mentor here at Temple Sinai. It was hard to choose just one teaching from him to share with you. Here so very excited to create our own singing community, our own traditions, our own legacies here together at Temple Sinai. Just want to say a few words of additional thanks. Rabbi Messler, I am beyond grateful for the way that you have ushered me into this community, devoting your time to teach me the ways and customs of Temple Sinai, taking time out of your busy schedule to study text with me each week, sharing meals at your home with me, encouraging me to find my own voice as Temple Sinai's encounter. This community and I, we are so incredibly lucky to have you at our home. My family, who traveled from Maryland to be here today, has supported me through multiple extracurricular interests and careers. Alex and Max have their own dinner, bath, and bedtimes, more nights a week than you probably would like. I know it's not easy having a mom who's away so often. My in-laws, I can't imagine having this career without your support, your food that gets on our dinner table, quite a lot, your care of Max, all in the midst of your own busy careers. The committee who put today's party together, led by Essie and Jay, staff at Temple Sinai, Amy and Janet and Beth, John and Maria and Glenn, choir, led by Carol Martin, and Arnold for helping out with the sound. Thank you so much for being here. And last but not least, everybody who came out to support me, thank you so much for singing with me.
Shir Ladonai, Shir Hadash, Shir Ladonai, Kol Haaretz, Cantor Becky Khitrik. We welcome you to a new chapter in the life of our congregation and in the journey of your cantor. We stand with you before the open ark to offer a blessing of welcome and thanksgiving at this sacred time. We welcome you as you bring your voice to this congregation as its cantor. When we sing God's praises, we open our hearts to the possibility of spiritual renewal. May you comfort us with old melodies and inspire us with new songs. May your gift of music with voice, clarinet, and guitar, choir conducting and teaching, help us sing new songs to God, inspire us to spiritual fulfillment, and help us find new meaning in the prayers of our hearts. The words of the Torah are lyrics, and as such, their full meaning is incomplete without music. You are, therefore, not only our prayer leader, but also our teacher of Torah. Teach us the words, the melody, and the kavanah, the meaning. You wish for this congregation to be a singing community. May you be invigorated by this community's particular Torah, and may this congregation be one that learns to sing with you. Ultimately, let these songs bring us to holiness and mitzvot.